Well, I get the closing remarks, which is exciting because I've really benefited so much from being here. I thank you so much for the opportunity. I thank Senator Burris, Congresswoman Clark, as well as Congressman Clay. And I bring you greetings from Atlanta, Georgia, where I am president of Velvet Suite Marketing. And really, what I have the privilege of doing every single day, I think, is finding my life's purpose and helping people discover their passion, how to package it, promote it, and profit from it. And that's what we call a brand. How many of you have heard of the term personal branding in the room? It's one of the hottest buzz terms right now. And I'd like to say that I really am an authority in this. My pedigree is in corporate America. I started at Victoria's Secret and Procter & Gamble, built the Swiffer brand, and also have moved on to work with celebrities, athletes, corporations, in terms of educating individuals on their power of purpose and understanding how to position that in the market. You understand that in the first 3 seconds of someone meeting you, they've already made up your mind about who you are, and within the first 7 seconds, they've changed their mind multiple times. Seems schizophrenic, but understand that in a day and age when we are cluttered with information, ideas, all these things coming at us at one time, it is very important that whether it's your individual brand or if it's your company brand, that you're very clear on your position. So I'm going to give a few tips to you, and I also will quickly leave you, if you have your cell phones, I'm sure your cell phones are off, but when you turn them back on, I'll give you something to test, and then you will get an email back with an actual action plan for building your brand, because I can't go over all of that right now. You can text Velvet Suite, VelvetSuite, and it's all caps, Velvet Suite, and 278247. So it's the text number is 78247, and the what you'll text is Velvet Suite, all in caps. So, you know, quickly, like I said, I'm very passionate about what I do, and I truly count it a privilege to be here because I come from a small town. My grandfather picked up cans in Gary, Indiana, and he became branded as a can man because he was helping to ensure that his children went to college, and thus my father was the first to go to college, and then I was able to do so, and my sister as well. But in building a brand, it really starts with understanding your core purpose. And I think it's very important. When we're doing our business, we are very passionate about, or maybe it's just something that you're skilled and you're very adept at doing, but understanding how to package that with a purpose to serve a unique need. I think the reason we're all in this room right now is because the world is full of challenges. At this very moment, you can turn on the news, you can have a conversation at your home, or you can be out with friends, and you can have a list of the issues that are going on in the world. It's not an issue. Brand masters find a way to solve the problem. So it's really all about how you're going to position yourself as a solution to a problem. And each one of these agencies and individuals have talked about needs. So your uniqueness is going to be how are you going to position yourself to be distinct, different, and relevant in the context of everyone else who's constantly sending them emails, phone calls, trying to get the opportunities that we all want in this room. So number one is defining the purpose. Number two, I think the difference that really helps grow and where we want to be in terms of what Congressman talked about is sustainability, and that's having a process. And I know in the room there's pretty probably extreme variations of types of businesses and longevity in business, but the core goal here is to understand that process is critical to growing a brand. It's not about just getting buzz and getting your name out there. It's really about creating a business and a strategy for growth. And that's really critical. The next step I would leave you with is packaging. Packaging your pitch. And that pitch is just as critical in 30 seconds or less. I call it the tight and skinny pitch. You need to be able to give it to someone when they meet you. You need to be able to write it in an email, a subject line like Twitter. That's how many characters you've got, and that's how much opportunity you have to shoot someone's attention. Now listen, we don't want to give them the menu. You just want to give them an appetizer because that's the opportunity that's going to bring interest to begin to shape opportunity for you. And again, your job is really to separate yourself from the clutter, separate yourself from the competition. And I believe that when you discover brand me, which is your authentic mark, no one can ever beat you at being you. There is no competition. You're in a category of one. And so I'm really excited because I think that there's so much potential in the room. There's so much opportunity for us. But it's really up to us to be proactive versus reactive, really strategically positioning ourselves because as entrepreneurs, I'm one. I know time is of the essence. Time is money. And we don't have a lot of it. So we've got to make every move count. We've got to make every opportunity meaningful. So I would just encourage you, as you're networking, and I'll be here as well to talk about how we may be able to help you, or just some tips as you're thinking about branding, possibly repositioning your company, even looking at strategic partnerships. At the end of the day, you as an entrepreneur cannot do it by yourself. I can't do it by myself. But in this economy, we can partner. We can create strategic alliances that will help us win. And I think that's what all of us want. So again, thank you so much for the opportunity, and I'll be here for questions.
Great. Thank you.